Hello friends, today we are going to say the second numerical of type B. In the first numerical of type B, we have seen how we can solve the numerical when the surface is inclined. Now the second numerical is also on the same concept, type B. But the thing is, in the previous case, the nature of the force was pull type. And today we are going to see the numerical when the force is in push type. So the directions of the external applied force will be in a opposite directions of the pole than the pole type. Okay. Now come to the real example, and there we will get the proper idea about, because most of the time we may do the some mistakes at the time of solving the numerical. That's why I have prepared the another video for this push type. Now this is the numerical type B. Example second, a wooden block is resting on a rough inclined plane whose inclination to the horizontal is 10 degree. So here mention the inclination to the horizontal is 10 degree means this numerical is related to the type B, not to the type A. The smallest force acting parallel to the line of the greatest slope, which will just move the block down the plane. Block down the plane. So the block is going downward due to the applications of 2 Newton force. So move the block down the plane is 2 Newton. Okay. So when we apply the 2 Newton force on the body will slide down. So the functions, I hope that you got the idea. In the pull type, the case was different. The block was moving upward. Now here the block is moving downward. So the directions of the external force magnitude is 2 Newton, is moving downward. In the previous case, the force was taking or responsible to move the body in upward. That's why the directions of the force was this. Correct? Now you got the idea about, and this is the main important point of this numerical. So the two things has to consider. One is which type, the type B related numerical or type A related numerical, and the second thing is which types of the force nature. Otherwise the whole diagram will be same. Now if the coefficient of friction between the block and the plane is 0.32 means mu, so we have the theta value 10 degree Celsius, 10 degree. We have the force value 2 Newton force, external force, and we have the coefficient of friction in between the surfaces 0.32, mu is equal to 0.32. Estimate the weight of the block. Estimate the weight of the block. So in this diagram or in this numerical, we have to find out W. So in the previous numericals, we have finded out the P, external force, or somewhere we have find out the mu, but here is the case different. Today we are going to find out the W. So I already told you in the first lecture of this chapter that basically for the three things the numerical comes: to find out the external force, to find out the coefficient of the friction, and to find out the weight of the block. So today you have to find out the weight of block. Again the procedure is not different, the procedure is totally the same, but you should get the idea how we can compare the one equation with the other. That's why today's numerical is. So the main is we have this given data. So theta is nothing but the alpha here. So you can see here in this diagram, this will be the theta. And when the W gets downward, that time whatever the extension coming of the resultant force, that in between these two arrow, this force also will be the same as like the theta, but we don't mention that angle by the theta, we mention it by the alpha, but always that theta is nothing but the alpha. Now our aim is to find out w. So our aim is to find out w. Now comes to the real solution. To find w, step 1, for limiting equilibrium, again the summations of all the vertical forces equal to 0. Now first of all, before going to the solution, you need to draw the diagram. So here is the diagram. We can see the inclined plane is there, and this inclined plane is making 10 degree angle with the horizontal. Then next thing, we have to show the block on the inclined plane. So this is the block we have placed on the inclined plane, and the block is having its own weight. So that weight indicated by W, and always the weight will move downward, will be in a downward direction. So that's why the W has mentioned, and that is the vertical. Now the second case, due to the reactions in between the block and the surface, the resultant reaction force will act, the reaction force will act, and that reaction force will be perpendicular to the inclined plane, so this will be the R. And the second case, if the body is moving, then the frictional force also will develop. So the body is moving downward, means push type of force due to the external force, due to the external pushing nature force, body is moving downwards. So here is the force, but the direction is in downward direction. Remember, don't forget to show here the directions of P in this way, because on the basis of these directions of external force, the frictional force direction depends. So the friction will be opposite to this arrow, so this will be the frictional force. Okay, the direction of force is different, opposite. So as mentioned, the FP. Now comes to the next procedure. Next is, before the solution, we have to resolve the W. So here is the W. So this is the block, and on which the W is going downward, and we are getting the two component. We need to resolve this W into the two parts. So this will be the two part. So this will be the R. Okay, and this arrow will be the extension of R. So now in between these two arrow, the angle will be same, the 10 degree, the horizontal is mentioned by the W sine theta or sine alpha, and the second below arrow is mentioned by W cos alpha. Okay, cos alpha. And this will be the W. So at the time of solution, we don't consider the W, we consider only this subcomponent. If you have solved the previously given numerical, then I hope that you will not get the any kind of the problems related to it. Now, so in this diagram, I have shown the resolutions of this also, W cos alpha and W sin alpha. So instead of alpha, alpha value is 10 degree, so W cos 10. And here is also the alpha value, 10 degree means W sin 10. Okay. And F means the frictional force, so it is indicated by F is equal to mu into R. So mu R has mentioned, correct. Now we got the all forces here. And then just at the time of vertical force summation, we will consider this direction as positive and the directions of the force is negative. So how many forces are there in this direction? So R and this W component, W cos alpha. So R is in upward, so positive, and W cos alpha is in downward, so negative. So R minus cos alpha equal to 0, but we know the value of alpha. So we will put the alpha value 10, so W cos 10, and finally cos 10 value is 0.985 W. So this will be the R value. So indicate it by the equation number 1, correct. So the same procedure we did in the previous numericals also. So this problem is not that different than it, but you need to focus what the procedure we are following, and according to that you need to solve. Don't worry about which types of numerical coming, don't try to change your mind, or don't try to change your procedure. Now the step 2, According to step 2, do the summation of all horizontal forces, summation of f of x is equal to 0, and the sign convention will be in this direction. So block is this, and horizontal force means this will be the parallel forces to the inclined surface that we will consider here. So this force is positive and this force will be negative. Now here in this diagram we can see the f is in horizontal, w cos alpha also is in horizontal, p is also in horizontal. So these three forces are in horizontal or parallel to the inclined plane, we will say parallel to the inclined plane, sorry. Now f force, here we can see the f force is in upward, so upward means positive, so f positive. Now the second force is w sin alpha, so w sin alpha is in downward, so it will be negative. So here we can see this is the negative, so w minus w sin alpha. Now the next force is p, p is again downward, in a downward direction, so downward direction means negative, again minus p equal to 0. The equation will form, instead of the f we will write the mu into r. Then always we write the mu into r, because in the numerical they are giving us and mu and r value, that's why we need to take mu r. If in the numerical we have the value of f directly, friction force, then no need to take the mu r. So here we have mentioned the mu r minus w sin alpha minus p equal to 0. So mu value is given, that is the 0.32 into r is unknown, minus again put the value of alpha here 10, so sin 10 value will be 0.174 and w will be multiplied, minus again we have the p value is 2, so minus 2 equal to 0. This equation will form, and then comes to the second process. Now the condition is, substitute the value of r of equation 1 into equation 2. What will happen if we put this r value into this equation at the place of r? Okay, so the same thing we will do here. In the previous numericals also we have done the same thing, if you remember. Then put the r, this value, equation number 1 value into the equation number 2. So the same thing here. So put the equation number 1 into equation number 2. I have not mentioned here, this will be equation number 2, correct? So 0.32 into r minus 0.174 into w minus 2 equal to 0. This is the equation number 2, and in it we are going to put the value of r. R value is 0.985 into w. So instead of the r we have pasted 0.985 into w. So this value is multiplied with the 0.3232, and that all values I will write into the bracket, minus again 0.174 into w minus 2 equal to 0. Now you can see the only one unknown is here, and that unknown is w. Okay, that unknown is only a w. So these two brackets also having the same value, this bracket is also carrying the w value, this bracket also carrying the w value. So I will do first of all the multiplication of these two terms. So from that I will get 0.315 into w minus 0.174 w minus 2 equal to 0. Now here to the 2 w is not multiplied, so this term will be different. We couldn't directly subtract from the previous two terms. First of all we need to do the subtractions in between these two. So when we do it, then 0.141 into w, this value we will get. I will shift this to at the another side, so it will convert into the 2 positive. And when to find out the w, I will shift this 0.141 value here in the opposite direction, then the value of w will be 14.18 newton, and that will be the answer of our numerical. So in the answer we were requiring the weight of the block, and the weight of block is 14.18 newton. I hope that you all got the idea about the numerical. Numerical is so simple, but your focus is important. Now, today I will give the short homework to you. You no need to solve this numerical, but just have to draw the diagram related to this numerical. Don't solve the numerical, only draw the diagram related to this numerical, and that will be your assignment for today. I hope that you all got the idea. Still you have any new query about it, then you may do the message on WhatsApp. Thank you.